Hello, Freunde des Lichts. My name is Sean, and welcome to my channel. I decided to take part in the Thomann Build Your Own Kit Guitar Contest, and I went with the CTS24 design. So I just unpacked it and had a look at it. Yeah, it's not perfect, but it's also 90 bucks. So what can you expect? So why am I doing this? I wanted to sharpen my paint skills and try something new. And also a friend of the family wanted to help out and what I'm doing. And so basically this is already paid for, so my wife can't complain about me getting another guitar. And yeah, I'm gonna do a little bit of shaping on the headstock, maybe clean up the guitar, some of the woodworking here, but not really do anything else to it. I really like the general design of the PRS guitars. I thought I didn't like the heel, but in this one it's actually not at all an issue. So I'm not gonna really do anything on shaping the guitar. I'm just gonna mostly clean it up, paint it, shield it a bit, and hand it over. First, I'm gonna go ahead and assemble it and see how everything fits up. Got it all tuned up and playing like a dream. Yeah, the strings are actually pretty nicely centered, so I'm gonna take it back apart and start painting it. First, I wanted to clean up a little bit of the rough machining and sand the coat of sealer. Then I used up a can of 2K primer from Spraymax on the body and level sanded and cleaned it before I began painting it. I used that black primer as a strong contrast to the color because I'm attempting the PRS foil finish, because I think it will really look neat coupled with my headpieces, which you probably don't know what I'm talking about unless you're close to me, but there will be more about that in the future. Here I'm using the sparkling silver candy base color from a paint company in the Netherlands called Crop, and I always start with the side before doing the back and top. This is the actual speed, but for subsequent shots I show it sped up to 4 times the speed. I learned that the candy paint dries pretty fast, maybe even too fast for my purpose. Using cans like this really isn't the best way to do this, and in the future I'm definitely going to have to move faster with the disruptive padding down. I think a better way would be to use a paint gun and really spray a thick layer, which would take longer for the paint to dry and produce better results, but I don't have a gun and I don't really plan to get one in the near future, so I think I'll just stick with the plan of moving faster. I used a paper and plastic bag from a bakery to create this effect, and I just patted against the paint a bunch of times, but again, I didn't get quite as much disruption as I was going for. After that, I applied a couple coats of this transparent marine blue. finally I applied about 6 coats of the 2K Spray Max Clear Gloss and sanded and polished it, which was a big challenge on this body shape with all of its contours and hard edges, if you know what I mean. After shielding the electronics and pickup cavities, I got to working on the headstock and changed it from that weird Harley Benton thing to this simple design with a bevel on the top. And I sanded the lacquer off the neck. I then added an inlaid logo, which I'll probably try to use CNC for next time if possible, since this wasn't an exceptionally clean job. Finally, I applied an oil finish to the neck, then went over it with 3/0 steel wool, followed by another coat of oil, then 4/0 steel wool and a final coat of oil, and rubbed it hard and smooth with a cloth, and finally assembled it again. Here's what it sounds like. Two pickups together, I think those were pretty nice sounds. And initially I wasn't really impressed with the bridge pickup. I tried it out with a little bit of metal and it always sounded a little bit trebly. I think I was using it wrong though. I played around a little bit with the amp sims and came up with a much better tone for it. I think it would work pretty decent for rock and blues and stuff like that. But yeah, here's what it sounds like in a metal context. And now with the whole mix. Time with me. I hope you like this. I certainly did. I learned a lot and I look forward to doing some more stuff like this in the future. So until then, take care and I'll see you then. Tschüss.